church. Good morning to all those who listened this morning. I greet you in the name of the Lord to another day in the house of the Lord. It is a glory to be in his house. The song been on my heart for a while. I'm asking one of our brothers to come up and sing it for us. I pray that it bless your spirit and soul like I know it's going to bless mine. Amen. Amen.
I know I've been changed.
For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the deep places of the earth. The strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his, and he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Today, if ye will hear his voice, harden not your heart, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness. When your fathers tempted me, proved me, and saw my work. 40 years long have I grieved with this generation, and said, it is a people that do err in their heart, and they have not known my ways. Unto whom I swear in my wrath, they should not enter into my rest. Amen. The Lord, the hearers and doers of his words be blessed. Well, Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning, Father God, with bowed heads and sometimes heavily burdened in our hearts, Father God. Father, we come to you, Father God, because we know no one else to turn to. There's no one else like you, Father God. And we ask this morning, Father God, first off, for forgiveness. Forgiveness for what we've done, sins we've committed, Father God. Sins that we unintentionally committed. Father God, we just ask you to wash us. Wash us in the blood of Jesus, Father God. Allow us to raise our heads to the hills where our help and strength cometh, Father God. Father God, we seek you this morning. First, we ask you to touch those in the bed of affliction this morning, Father God. Those behind prison walls, Father God. Sometimes it takes prison to open our hearts, Father God. We just ask you this morning to bless those, Father God. Father God, we ask you to touch the hearts and minds of those who didn't give it a thought this morning. Touch those in foreign lands, Father God. Touch those that are persecuted in your name in other places, Father God. We know this is a trying time, Father God, and we continue to look to you for our help and our strength, Father God. We ask that you to guide our feet the way we should go, Father God. Bless the man who you put in this place to be the under-shepherd of this church, Father God. Let the light that shine from this place go forth and outside of this place, Father God, because we need you more and more every day, Father God. Father God, we just thank you for Jesus dying on the cross for our sins, Father God. And we know that one day we will have an everlasting place to live, Father God, in heaven. And we will continue to give you the praise and the glory. For it's in your Son, Lord Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. While I was in the bike, I didn't realize I didn't have any of the glasses. I'm seeing pretty good. I gotta throw them away here. Mama's team should have told me you look good without them glasses on. I'd have been all right. Amen. Let us now get ready as Joy and Reverend Benson lead us in a opening song of worship, and then we'll come back for our testimony time. Amen. We ask you to come up here because what is happening now, we got a camera that picks up everything. We don't want to see the back of your head. I was coming up, I didn't like nobody to be behind me. I thought I had the ugliest head in the world. Amen.
Amen. God is good all the time. The song simply says, our God is awesome. If he's been awesome to you, I'm just going to ask you to stand where you are and just worship with us. He can move mountains. He's moved mountains. He's kept you in the valley. He's kept you during this pandemic. Hallelujah. My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keep me in the valley, hide me from the rain. My God is awesome. Heals me when I'm broken. Strength where I am weak, and forever he will reign.
I like to give honor to God, you know, and as Joy was just singing, he is awesome. And I just have to get up and testify how awesome he is. We've all been through a lot this last year, individual families, as we've gotten sick in, some of us have lost loved ones. And God has been really awesome to us. that we can still be here and praise him and bless his holy name. And I like to thank him for what he's done for my family. He's awesome. He's brought my husband out of a really bad, bad situation. And I like to just thank God. He's awesome. He's mighty, you know, and prayerfully we can get back. We can get back. We're coming back. We got a new beginning. We got a new president, you know, and God knows he is awesome. And he's here for each and every one of us. And I like to thank God for each and every one of you, your prayers and gatherings. And thank you, you know. And thank God.
Amen. Anyone else? Sister Maxine, it's good to see you, daughter. Good to see you. We're holding you in prayer.
You know, I would like to say that God is awesome. I have been through quite a bit since right before Christmas, but God has brought me through it. I've lost my sister, my husband is sick, but I still try to be strong because God, he's the only one that gives me the strength to keep going. I am weak, but thou art strong. Mm-hmm. I am weak, but thou art strong. And I thank him each and every minute, moment, second of my life because he is so good.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Bless you, Pastor. Everybody in their respectable places. My pastor, Pastor Pastor John Max here at the Lost Sheep Ministries. I couldn't sit down on God, so I just decided to come up and just thank God for making it to his house one more time. Mm-hmm. My heart is just so overfilled with so many things I want to thank him for, but I know he knows. The main thing is I thank y'all for this church. I thank God for this church because when I moved here from New York almost 2 years ago, I found comfort in this church through my grandmother and Denise Corpany and Herbert Corpany, and they brought me. And in that, I was able to bring my family after a year, and my brother, and, you know, his wife and his mother-in-law and my kids. So I'm just thankful because just new beginnings, new levels. I know that there's new devils and everything. You know, they say new level, new devil. But I thank God because he has no power here. Amen. And I thank God for, because my parents instilled in me when I was very young to know how to pray, you know, and I thank God for that because I said this year, I mean, about a year ago when I came and I was by myself and I was going through so much, so much. I mean, I felt like the enemy was attacking me on so many different levels, and all I knew was how to pray because that's what my parents instilled in me. And I thank God because, you know, my grandmother would bring me here and I wouldn't come as much. I was always finding an excuse or just body be tired, just physically, like I ain't want to be there. But I thank God because I would still like go off and pray because it was still instilled in me as a kid that no matter what, you pray. So I thank God for prayer, though, because the prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And faith without works is dead. So I would continue to pray. But, you know, people feel like once they pray, you set and forget it. Yeah, you leave it in God's hand, but you have to listen and you have to do, you know what I mean? You have to take that step. You got to have that mustard seed faith to step out. And I thank God because y'all just, time from then to just now, just a year ago, how God has like really shown me his face. Like.
Amen. Amen. Crazy.
I'm thankful, y'all, because it keeps telling me. I never said the weapon wasn't going to form. I said it wouldn't prosper. Yeah. Thank you. That's all I'm going to say. Y'all, thank you.
Amen. Amen. Take your time. Come on, Reverend. Amen. Amen. We need to hear from time to time. Reaffirm our faith in our great God and Savior.
Amen. Good morning, Shiloh.
Good morning.
You know, I'm not one to get up and testify, but thank God for Shiloh. And this is something that's not done in churches anymore. A chance to tell about how what God has done and how good he is. I just wanted to share, because the Sunday school lesson almost had me speechless this morning. I wanted to share because God still speaks. Just before Christmas, I needed to cook on the grill. The next day was scheduled to rain. So after a long day, I came in and I pulled it together and I said, well, I need to cook these ribs now because it's going to rain tomorrow. And after toiling and finishing up cooking, the Holy Spirit told me to put out the fire in the grill. And of course, I decided to wet the ground under the grill instead of following the instructions. When I got up the next day, the fire had come out the grill, burned up one of the tires on the grill, burned up all of the wood that I had sitting on the side of the grill, burned up a pallet, and the ground was leaves. But what saved the house was the grace of God.
Amen.
God allowed it to rain to put out the fire.
Amen. 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 Thank you. Thank you. My brothers and sisters, we are so grateful. We need to hear the miracle power that God is still working. God is still protecting us. So this morning, if you have your Bible, visit with me to the book of Isaiah chapter 40. A very familiar passage of scripture. I preached it some time ago, and the Lord would not allow me to get away from Isaiah 40, focusing really on that verse 31. The youth shall faint and be weary, young man that utterly fall, but they that what? Wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. I want to speak from a subject, strength to keep going. We need some strength to keep going. So after the choir sang, however, Reverend Vincent and Joy, they can do A, B, C, or D. It doesn't matter. Amen? But as we worship,
because the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything I need. He lets me rest in the meadow's grass, and he leads me beside the quiet stream. He restores my failing health, and he helps me to do what honors him the most. That's why I'm saved. That's why I'm saved. That's why I'm saved. Do what? That's why I'll say, I'll say, in His presence, when the storms, of life are raging,
it's call your attention here to a few verses, Isaiah chapter 40. We'll pick up at verse 27. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my just claim is passed over by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faint nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak. Those who have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young man shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. You may be seated. Gracious God, our Father, forgive us for our sins. Shield and protect us now from the enemy of our minds who will try to thwart your word and hinder it from being preached by the power of the Holy Spirit. Bless the waiting congregation and those who are listening. And Father, we thank you now. In the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Use another thought this morning. Threat to keep going. How do you keep going under the circumstances we're living in right now? How do you keep going with the coronavirus? How can we keep going with the ups and the downs? Are you too weak to go on. My brothers and sisters, we are facing some discouraging times. There are times when life becomes very hard and difficult. We feel like quitting. Everything presses upon us. Our outlook on life becomes very dim, very bleak. Even our faith in God sometimes. We cannot see our future in what's going on. And yet, we got to keep on going. Many of us have lost the desire to go on. We just want to throw in the towel and give up. We find ourselves facing days of weariness, depression. All of these things are pulling at the soul of God's people. Some are so discouraged they're even thinking about it. Some have committed suicide. I was talking with someone the other day and I said it not tongue in cheek. I'm surprised that not more people are not taking their lives, especially those that don't have a relationship with the Lord. We are overwhelmed with difficulties. We find ourselves wondering, how can I go on? Really, is it worth it to try to go on now? Talk to me, somebody. Would I be better off if I was dead? Wouldn't have all the problems I'm going through. Getting old, my health is failing me. Family has forsaken me. And God does not look like he hears my prayers anymore. Anybody here know what I'm talking about? But you're the preacher. You're the deacon. You're a child of God. But yet, I don't feel like going on anymore. Last night, I was finding a song in my printer was messing up. The old song. My heavenly home is so bright and fat, I feel like traveling on. I got it and got the lyrics and it packed me up, Sister Ursary. My heavenly home is so bright and fair. I feel like traveling on. I'm not ready to stop moving now. The prophet Isaiah had seen and faced many difficult times in his life. His name Isaiah means the Lord has saved. He's the author of the book named after him. He recorded events of King Uzziah's death. King Uzziah became powerful. His pride messed him up, caused his downfall. He took things in his own hand because he thought it was strong enough, but he didn't wait on the priest that God was going to send. Sometime I'm trying to get you to see, my brothers and sisters, no matter what you're going through, you got to learn to wait on God and get strength from God if you're going to go on. It's a dangerous to intrude in places when God did not send you there. Because Uzziah couldn't wait to get his strength from God. He was stricken with leprosy until the day he died. As I said, Isaiah had saw many weaknesses in the history of the children of Israel. Isaiah had saw the sinful weakness of the nation. He saw the sinfulness of the king. He saw all of these things. And yet Isaiah himself faced that same thing. But he didn't want to go on. And he said, in the year that King Uzziah died, I also saw the Lord. He was at the pinnacle of his falling. But he saw the Lord. And any time you see the Lord, he'll give you strength to go on. And God began out there thought about what? Comfort. Comfort my people, said the Lord. Speak tenderly to Judah. What God is saying, I know what they're facing. And even then, as he said, speak tenderly, they still had another 70 years in captivity. But God said, speak comfortable to them. Why? Because he knew the pains and the tribulations that they were going through. They had reached their wit's end. And somebody here today, you at the wit's end of life. But I'm telling you today, there's strength to keep on going. Anybody need some strength this morning to keep on going? The question is, Pastor, how do I get the strength to keep on going? How do I even move from where I seem to be locked down at right now? First thing is patience. If you're going to wait on God, it takes patience to wait on God. If you want the strength to keep on going, you got to what? Wait on God. Psalms that say, I waited patiently for the Lord. He inclined unto me and heard my cry. Psalms 41, and what the psalmist said, I know what I was going through and I needed to go on, but I had to wait patiently until God gave me strength to go on. And somebody here, don't get in a hurry, but sit down and wait on God, and God will give you strength to go on. Yes, I know we want some things to change right now. We want things to flip right now. But God has said, you've got to be patient and wait on me, and I'll give you the strength to go on. I know where you are. I know what you're going through. But if you wait on me and give me the time, I'll work everything out. I'll give you the strength to go on. Amen, amen, and amen. Wait patiently on God. Our quest to go on, we cannot continue in our own power. But if you wait on God and patiently wait, he'll give you the strength to go on. That's why Uzzah messed up. He couldn't wait on God. Don't mess up by trying to get ahead of God. Don't become impatient with what you're going through. But say, I'm going to wait, as Job said, until my change comes. I'm going to wait until God moves by his power and give me the strength to get up. You may be knocked down right now, but stay down until God lift you up like self-rising flower. If you wait on God, he'll lift you up and move you forward. Amen, amen, and amen. Strength to go on. I know we are weak and weary. I know we are tired of the coronavirus. We are tired of all the stuff around us. We are the children of God, but yet God said, wait. Now I'll give you the strength to go on. The second thing, God promised to help you fly. Look at the text. They was complaining. Why do you say, O Jacob, speak, O Israel, my ways are hidden from the Lord, and my just claim is passed over? And God asked, have you not known? Do you really know me? Have you not heard about me? Huh? You not had a testimony about who I am? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the end of the earth, do you know I'm not weary, neither do I faint? God said, you done forgot who I am? You've lost all the knowledge about me? Israel had forgotten what God had done in their life. And don't you forget what God had done in your life. Look what he says. He neither faint nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. So I'll give you then, he said, he gives power to the weak. God is saying, I know you're weak. I know you don't want to go on, but I got some power that I can give to the weak. Our problem is we want to be strong and we're Atlas and Hercules. But there's a time in your life you got to lay down on God and let God know I'm weak and I'm weary and I can't go on. If you don't lift me up and carry me, I'll die right where I am. But you got the power, the authority to lift me up, and he will lift you up and move you forward. That's how you go on. You're weak. Says he give you promise to help you fly. Look what this text says. He gives them, even the youth shall faint. I don't care how young and strong you are. There's some stuff coming down the pipe that knocked you down on your knees. You shall faint and be weary. Young man shall utterly fall. You may be 6 feet two, 240 with muscles everywhere, but if you stay living, you one day you'll find yourself falling. But there's a God who got the power to lift you up again. You shall faint and be weary. Young man shall utterly fall, but the kid, but they that who? Wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. To renew means shall exchange their weakness for the strength that comes from above. That's what renewal is. It's an exchanging. God want to exchange with you. I want to take your weakness and give you strength to rise up and go on in my grace and mercy. He promised, sister and brother, the Lord is going to help you fly. You shall faint and be weary. He helps us fly. There are some trials and tribulations we face in this life. We cannot go around them. We can't go over them. We can't go on them. We can't do anything. But wait, and when we wait on God, he'll give us wings like an eagle that you can get up and fly over the stuff. And you fly, eagle fly high enough that everything gets small. He wants you to get high enough that the stuff you're looking at is so small, you cannot see it. All you can see is the great God who is high and lifted up. I don't see the problem. I see God. Amen, amen, and amen. He want to give you the strength this morning to fly above the stuff you're going through. He want to give somebody the strength to fly out of the mess you find yourself in this morning. He want to give you strength to keep on going. You ever seen a little bird when they're born? How they flop and fall? Some of us are like that. But if you look to the hill which come your help, every day you get a little more strength in the wings. And one day the little bird is no longer flying or falling. You see him get up and soar up and look around and say, "Quick, I got it now. I'm moving with the Lord." And that's what we got to do. That's what we got to do. Lord, help me this morning. He gives us strength to keep on going. Paul said in 2 Corinthians 12:10, "There I take pleasures in infirmities, in reproach, in needs, in persecution, in distress, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I'm strong." When I'm weak, then I'm strong. Because Christ gives us the strength to go on. Anybody here know what I'm talking about? I didn't intend to go this way, brothers and sisters, but he gives us strength to go on. Yes, we all face the weaknesses of life, but he will help us to fly over the stuff. They that wait on the Lord shall renew, exchange their strength, and then they go, what? Mount up with wings like an eagle. Let me tell you something about eagle. Eagle don't get up real fast because he's so big. His wingspan sometimes reaches 25, 30 feet. He could get up real slow. And after a while, when he gets airborne, he gets high enough, he goes through the air, and you can hear his wings singing. Ooh, he's cool. And God wants some of us to get up this morning and start saying, "I'm flying on the eagle wing that God has given me." Amen, amen, and amen. There's some tragedies in life that you got to go through, but God will give you wings to fly through it. I tell them, I'm not boasting, I'm not looking for pity. I lost my two brothers and my sister-in-law, and somebody said, "How do you go?" Because I'm standing with some eagle wing. They're not my wing, but God got under my wing, and God is flying. I'm just riding on what God is doing. I'm just sailing on the power of God. If I was sailing on my own, I never would get up. But because of the great God, I can sail up above the problems. Yes, he want to help you to fly. and he'll give you wings. Whew. God help us. Then not only give you wings, but he give you what? Strength. He want to help you run. There's some stuff that God is going to deliver you from. You got to run through it. You got to go through it. And when you run through it, God said, don't hesitate. I don't want you to hesitate what you're going through. Because you start looking at what you're going through and you'll stop. But if you run through it with your eyes on the prize, if looking to the hill which come your help, you don't see all the stuff around you. You are running this race with patience, looking to Jesus, the author and the finish of your faith, and you'll get through it. Somebody's going through something today. Quit sitting around, moping about it. Oh no, if the Lord gonna do it. I don't know, but the Lord is saying, get up and run through it. Run through it. I'll give you strength to run through it. Whew. He promised to give us strength to run through it. God wants to enable you to run through it. Jeremiah said in his writing, if thou hast run with the footmen and they weary thee, then how can I contend with the horses? If the land and place wherein trust they weary thee, how will thou do in the swelling of the joy? If you can't run through the little stuff you face now, how you gonna go through when the big stuff come tumbling down? You got to learn how to run through little stuff to get strong enough to spin through big stuff. God wants some spinners in here who can spin and run through some stuff without looking to see who behind you and what's in front of you. He want to give you the strength to help you run through some stuff. Our problem is we get stuck there, Reverend Benson, and we sat there in a pity parlor. Then we want to call folk like Job's friend, and they come sit and look at us too. You need to, when you're going through something, let me say this, thank you, Holy Spirit. When you're going through something, you need to be very selective who you let run with you, who you let be around you. You better be very selective of the folks you tell about what you're going through. There's some folks will be glad to see you catching hair, but don't tell them. But you all see them, and you don't have to lie about it. I'm blessed and highly favored, knowing you're going through stuff. Said the Lord is taking care of everything I got going on. That's how you go through. He's going to give you threat to help you run. Look what the text said. You shall faint and be weary, young man, the other fall, but those who wait on the Lord shall what? Renew, exchange their threat. They might have waned. Look what he said. They shall run. First, he wants you to fly over it. Next, he wants you to run through it. Hmm? You've flown over it so you see what's down there. Now, when you go back, guess what? Run through it. Just take off. I'm with you. Matter of fact, I have already paved the way. The road is smooth. Quit looking at the rough stuff. Quit singing, I'm coming up the rough side of the mountain. When is the Lord going to smooth that rough side up? Where you can just walk up the rough side. We sang some song, I'm coming up the rough side. Well, I ain't got no rough side. I'm coming up the smooth side. Because Jesus have made it what? Smooth to go up that side of the mountain. Y'all help me this morning. Y'all pray with me this morning. Reverend Vincent, I'm glad you don't play some of my old song. I'm coming up. It may be good at that time. But if you know the Lord, you don't have to always be coming up. When you gonna get to the mountaintop and look down where you come from? Sometimes the Lord ought to tell you to the mountaintop. Yeah.
He want to give you strength to go to the top. Quit hanging around at the bottom looking up. Oh, it's rough up there. No, I want to get you sewn up to the top. He helps you run. First, fly, run. Now he wants you to what? Walk through it. Look what it said. They shall run. And part of running, you're not weary. Because when you run with the Lord, he gives you strength not to look at the distractions. Too many of us are looking at the stuff that distracts us. Don't be like Peter. Want to walk on the water. Soon as he got off the boat, the first wave said, flap, flap, boom. We start walking with the Lord, and the first time the devil said, whoo, we stop walking. He give you thrift what? They shall run and not be what? Weary. He want to give you thrift and not be weary of what you think will catch up with you. The late Satcher Page says, run and don't look back. Looking back, somebody may be gaining on you. We keep looking back and the devil catch up with us. I know the devil right there somewhere. Well, why don't you outrun him? The scripture said, draw nigh to the God and resist the devil, he'll flee from you. Which means draw nigh, you ought to run to God. Resist the devil, he'll flee from you. Run. Then look, they shall what? Walk. And when you walk with God, you're not in a hurry. It's not like when you're in the Kroger and your wife pushing the cart to get the food. And you know it's time to pay Dr. Mike, and you see it's time to pay, you see the men in a hurry. Because he don't want to pay. That ain't what he said. He said, praise the Holy Spirit. How many of you men like that when you go to the store? Your wife pushing you in a hurry, like you got to go somewhere. But he said, walk, not run, walk. They shall walk. Which means you're walking in pace with God. You're walking slowly. You're observing where God done brought you from. Because what? You're observing the strength that I have to walk through this stuff. And when I walk through the fire, it will not burn me. When I go through the flood, the waters won't touch me. I'm walking with God. He give me the strength to walk through this stuff. That's why the psalmist said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? For thou art with me. They shall what? Walk. I want you to fly. Learn how to fly over it. I want you to run by it. Now I want you to just what? Walk through it without complaining. And without what? Fainting. He want to give you strength this morning to go on. My brothers and sisters, God want to strengthen you today because God want to keep us going on. He knows about the coronavirus. He knows our health issues. He knows our finances condition. He knows everything about us. But then God say, I want to give you strength to keep on going. I'm not through with you yet. I'm not finished with you yet. There's still some things I want to do in your life. There's still some places I want to take you. There's some victory I want to give you. There's still some blessing I want to bless you with. So I got to give you strength to keep on going to where I want to take you and bless you where I'm going to take you. That's why we got to keep on going. Do you want the strength to keep on going? Or do you want somebody to pity you this morning? We all are catching it from time to time. There's things we all are going through. But if you're a child of God, he wants you to go on. And I say this, I get ready to close. Those of you considering quitting, those of you considering not going on, can you look at the cross right now? Can you see Jesus stumbling up Golgotha's hill, carrying your cross of sin? He didn't quit. And when they saw him going up, they sent Simon to surrender. Simon didn't have to help Jesus with no cross because Jesus was going to get to that cross because God had signed him. He's going to get to the cross. He had the strength to get to the cross because he was carrying my sin, your sin, but he was going to get to the cross for you and I. He had the strength to keep going. He went all the way to Calvary. He died on that cross. He was buried. They put him in a tomb, but he had the strength to get up on the third day morning with all power in heaven and earth. Beneath in his hand, he got the power. He want to threaten you because he can keep you. He want to mold you. You and I are still in the potter's hand. And we cause he's in his hand, he's spending us. There's some weaknesses he got to get out of us. There's some stuff he got to get out of us. And when he get through, we will have the strength to keep going. And as I close, we ought to say what the song writer said. I'm weak, and we will lead me and guide me along the way. He want to lead and guide you and strengthen you to keep going forward. If you're here and you never accepted Christ, the reason you can't go, you don't have the strength that he imparts to those who receive him as Lord and Savior. And he gives us the strength to keep going. If you're here and you're about to give up, I challenge you, don't give up. Underline what he says in his word. Even the youth shall faint and be weary. Young men shall utterly fall, but those who wait, those who exchange their weaknesses for the threat that come from above. Reverend, whatever the Lord lay on your heart. My brothers and sisters, I've did what the Lord had told me to give you today. And I need it myself.
Strength.
Teaching the deacons here. Amen. Brother Rick, he's in the finance room. He's working already. Amen. But I'm grateful to God for what God's done. Now let me say this while he's doing that. I'm truly grateful to God for Reverend Holmes, Sister Holmes, Reverend Mike, and his family. Well, I'm grateful that God sent them this way. But most of all, I'm grateful that God is using them in this church. You know, God have a way, a place in people where he can use them, where he can continue their ministry. And who knows, he may have Reverend Magnus start a church. It ain't gonna hurt me because I'm gonna be right there to support him. Amen. But he's poured some things in the shallow that we need. Sister Mike, Reverend Holmes. God knows Reverend Dr. Willie Vincent poured everything we need. Especially when it comes to our music and his preaching. I've learned many churches don't grow because the pastor's too selfish. I don't want to ever be so selfish that I don't allow God to exercise the gift he give everyone. That's how church grows. When they can exercise their gift freely. Nobody have to ask pastor what I'm supposed to preach. That ain't my job. God called you, preach what God told you. If the arrow hit me, then I just say, ouch. Amen. But when God gives the men and women of God a free course to teach and preach his word, you can't muzzle them not to say what God has told them, give them the freedom to do what God called them to do. Brethren, go ahead. Thank you all. And yes. Okay. I understand that. Amen. But I want to say this and then we get ready to go. God has said, shallow haven't seen what God is going to do yet. Because of your faithfulness, those who are faithful that are coming, those who are faithful that are paying their tithes. They may not come, but they're paying their tithes. And you know, I'm not a pastor that's always hawking about money. Your commitment to God allows you to do what God called you to do. And because of that, the church is still going. But I do ask you prayers. The annex over there. And George, cut that off, because what I got to say, everybody don't need out there need to hear it. Amen.